between Pokemon trainer versus the opponent. His Charizard utilization, ridiculous.
Yeah,
I mean, just terrifying.
I think Pandarian definitely adopts kind of like as you said, like a Charizard, like he implements that. But I think that's kind of like the quintessential Pokemon trainer. You use all three for exactly their intended purpose.
Most definitely.
So we're starting out with Squirtle here, of course, to get those early bread and butter combos.
Yes, and on a character like Red, that's certainly going to be very easy, as you see right here, kicking it off. Okay, we're getting some forward air chains. He's rolling through them. Obviously trying to cross him up. The thing about Roy, though, especially from what we've seen, you know, we talk about Charizard and just like how we've started to realize how deadly he is. Roy is a character that, you know, was very deadly fresh out the gate in Smash Ultimate.
Ooh.
And then, like, as things kind of progressed, we started to sleep on him. But I think after Gamma, we realized how deadly this character can still be.
Yeah, and Ivysaur, of course, still a solid threat in his own. He just got that that high percent with Squirtle, and then he just started going in with Ivysaur here.
Boom,
and
up air again.
Yeah, oh. No real reason to change here.
Oh, I thought he was going to go for the second one, but yes, no reason to change here at this point. This is definitely what he's supposed to do here in this matchup. And Darren having just a ball with him, okay? Going for the back here. Couldn't quite get the follow-up off the dash attack. That could have certainly cost him a lot of percent right there.
Wow.
But Axel, a little late on the punish, finds himself off stage. And I love how he's avoiding being spiked. But what I don't love is how he's getting up off the ledge, though. You gotta respect forward smash from Ivysaur.
Yeah, he's definitely being, like, hasty. Because, like, you know, you're getting pressured so much. You're trying to find something. And, like, with Roy, like, you want to be that rushdown. But Pandarian is just playing, like, past that speed that Axel's trying to play at.
Oh, most definitely. Nice. Gets the forward. He's going to go for another one again. Absolutely. Oh, I like that. Just when you thought the stream was over, it was actually able to push you off with the tilt and the three stock to kick off the stream here. Smash the splash number five. Pandarian.
making quick work of that game number one. I think Axel, like, probably intended, like, maybe he was getting stage spike, so he kind of buffered that potential tech option instead of air dodge.
I think what threw me off was the forward tilt at the ledge
of
the platform. I was like, oh, what was that? Because anytime you see, like, forward tilt, or you see, like, bullet seed from Ivysaur, you always ask the question, like, was that intentional or was that an accident?
I mean, like, to be fair, it did cover, like,
everything.
Yeah, because, like, he jumped at him, and I guess that was the option. Either way.
So, yeah. Again, a very phenomenal start right there for Pandarian. Nothing short of greatness, as always. I mean, there's a reason why he is sponsored by Demise. Let's go ahead and kick it off to game at number two. We're actually going to one of my favorite stages, actually, Unova.
Thank you. I love this stage, too.
Really?
I'm so glad it's there.
Were you a 3DS guy, or do you just like the stage just by default?
I just like this stage because I just think it's – I like it better than the Pokemon Stadium, just the layout.
That's fair. The platform is a little higher, too.
Yeah.
I was actually I was a 3DS guy, you know, because I think I got a Wii U kind of late. So I was still playing 3DS for like that solid month and a half. I was like, you know, Unova ain't so bad.
Other than, you know, like the Pokemon here sometimes.
Yeah.
But we got hazards off.
Yeah, we got hazards off, man. This is a brand new game, obviously, but you certainly know how this script is going to go right here. And it's Pandarian.
That Vine Whip is deadly from so many ranges.
Most definitely. I love that, man. Always knows how to space it properly to get the sweet spot on it. Couldn't get the falling upper, but gets the regular upper right into the nair. And this assault is just not stopping. Sheesh.
Is the grab into the up-B. Not going to be the sweet spot, but still going to have to switch to Charizard so he can grab the ledge. But obviously, Charizard's going to be able to finish the stock off with a nice clean backer if he can get behind him.
Yeah, obviously, that's certainly a task within itself. Nice. Gets the wave on the platform. Keeps his positioning. That nair is actually going to do it. Takes Axel right out of the jump. And my man Axel right here, he's running out of answers. He's going to have to figure something out here pretty soon.
Oh, reverse nair.
Okay, regular nair that time. Couldn't get the falling upper. Whips the grab, and this is what you're supposed to do with Roy. You know, you get on top of a big character like Charizard, start crossing him up, start making it difficult for him to pinpoint where you're going.
Right.
Oh, but damn!
Where you're going is the blast zone. That's not difficult to figure out.
Lemon, that was some sour stuff right there, bro. I mean, holy hell.
All right, yeah, so Pandarian, with a quick, like, five-minute set.
Yeah.
Between games, too?
Yeah, Pandarian is production's worst nightmare. All right, you definitely need a little bit more time right there, man. But regardless, again, that was the game number one here. Smash Blast number five, Pandarian kicking it off in a very dominant fashion.